Here we have a drawing with a part that has to be manufactured. But we are particularly interested in this contour, where, as you can see, the coordinates and intersections are not dimensioned. How can we solve that quickly and easily in practice? Welcome to Cinemeric Live Did You Know? Today's topic is how does the contour calculator help me to complete this task although coordinates, in other words dimensions, are missing. Our contour, if we transfer it to the control system, we'll put it here, is going to be a pocket. The technologies are already predefined, roughing, residual material finishing, and now for contour entry. To do this, press Mill Contour, press New Contour, assign a name, and confirm. Now I need to define the starting point of the contour. It's going to be here, on the straight line. According to the drawing, that is minus 90 on the x-axis. Confirm. Now I go up, that is, on the y-axis in the plus direction to plus 30. Here too, we enter radius 5, which occurs 4 times. That means that it will be automatically calculated in the program. Confirm. Now continue clockwise, in this case to the right. And now we come to the first point that is not dimensioned. These are unknown coordinates. With a pocket calculator and various formulas, I could now calculate this using the mathematical functions for calculating the intersections, the coordinates. But we'll just leave the value we don't know empty. We simply continue with programming in the contour. What we do know at this point is radius 5, so we'll enter that. We enter as much as we know and leave the rest empty. We confirm, for the time being nothing has changed in the graphics. The system doesn't have the values. Despite this, we continue in the contour to radius 36. Select the radius, pay attention to the radius direction, then enter 36, and, of course, also enter the following element, again 5 mm, at the same time. We don't know the end of radius 36 on the x and y axes. And so we leave that empty too. What we do know is the center, that is, of radius 36. And in this case, it's exactly at our workpiece 0. So I enter 0 at I and J and press Apply. Now the system has enough information to suggest two variants to me. I can use Dialog Selection to select which geometry is the right one for me. That's the one we want. An intersection between the line to the right and the following radius 5 in radius 36. I select this dialog and confirm it. And here, shown in black, is the end element of radius 5, which we didn't have before. That's what we left empty. Let's go back in the sequence. This intersection up here was calculated by the system as minus 19.9. I left the value empty before as I didn't know it. Because I continued regardless, the system calculated it. I remember minus 19.9, go to the current program sequence and write exactly this value in X, minus 19.9, and confirm with OK. Now the system has adjusted the radius. We've also entered the following element, and now all we have to do is move to the left, so in the minus direction on the x-axis, and back to minus 90 according to the drawing. And then, of course, enter our radius, 5 again, confirm, and now just close the contour to complete the whole procedure. With OK, the contour is transferred to the program and assigned to the technologies mentioned. As I said, when you come across a point where you don't know what the coordinates are, either grab a calculator, a sheet of paper, pen, and calculate all the values, or just leave it empty, continue, and let the system calculate it for you. Of course, it's all a lot faster with the DXF import function. I refer you to the video DXF Import Made Easy for this. This video explains in detail how the whole procedure works in a simple and straightforward way. Thank you for watching and see you next time.